take a look at the programme and all the texts. You'll find those online on the St Catherine's website, and the extension is the girls-choir. So it's the girls' choir page of the St Catherine's website, and you'll see that there is a document there which you can download and view the programme and the texts. Now, our first group of pieces are all bird-related. We're going to start off with two pieces from the Aviary by Richard Rodney Bennett, and following that, a piece by Gerald Finzi, another reference to the linnet, and finally, in this little cluster, a piece which actually has a religious text by Alexander Lestrange on eagles' wings.
Thank you.
the Queen's music. And this is an a cappella piece, actually. It's a rather elaborate canon, which is about Scottish breeds of bird. And this is definitely nature read in tooth and claw. The text is also by Maxwell Davis, actually. And then the next, the final three pieces in this group are all texts from Robert McFarlane's wonderful book, The Lost Words, and set to music by James Burton. And they, in fact, we have been working on the whole set. There are 12 of these settings. We've been working on them sort of off and on during this curious year that we've had. And we very much hope to put the full set together next year for a project. We're going to give you three of them, three bird texts, magpie, lark, and then wren.
Thank you.
round of services in the chapel, not the music, kind of music that you've just heard, but sacred music. And we're going to give you four examples from our repertoire now, somewhat eclectic combination of pieces here. We're going to start with Arvo Pärt's Serene setting of the Lord's Prayer, Vater Unser, and then two pieces for All Saints, one Gaudens and Chalice by Deering, and then a more modern piece, Let All the Saints, a setting of text by Wesley by Alan Riddat, and then finally a piece which is much loved by the choir, a Passion Tide piece by John Ireland, Ex Ore Innocentium.
Thank you.
Murren. I know from viewing back some of these videos that the camera doesn't quite penetrate into that corner. So Alex, would you just take a few steps forward, just to show that we do have a real appearance here. This is Alex, and he is our junior, soon to be senior organ scholar, and he's had a lot of notes to play already, and he's going to play us a few more.
Thank you.
the end of our concert. Paddy, we'll ask you to keep the feed going if you don't mind. I'm hearing your distant applause, and we hope you enjoyed our little selection of pieces. Now, if you are part, as it were, of the St. Catherine's family, near family, then you'll be maybe interested to stay online for a moment, because we're going to say a few goodbyes, and we have a few little thank you gifts to give out. So, before I do that, one thing I need to announce first of all, which is that this is the time when I announce the winners of our two Dale Reed Memorial Prizes. This was a prize instigated last year, we were awarded them last year, and this is the second year we've been doing it. And there is one for a probationer and one for a chorister who has given particularly outstanding contribution to the choir. So the actual prizes will be formally given out on St. Catherine's Day, which is November the 25th, as part of our St. Catherine's Day service. But I announce them now, and I'm happy, delighted indeed, to announce that the winner of the probation prize is Penny McMurray. Fingers Wallace, who's been playing so many notes today. So thank you to Alex.